On our health corner, scientists warn that diphtheria is at risk of becoming a major global threat again as it evolves and becomes resistant to antibiotics. A study has warned that diphtheria, whose cases have exploded, is on track to once again become a major global threat as resistance to a number of classes of antibiotics evolves. Experts from the United Kingdom and India analyzed data from 512 samples of carrion bacterium diphtheria, the bacterium that causes the disease, taken between 1896 and 2018, along with a growing prevalence of genes that confer antibiotic resistance. The team found evidence that it could one day evolve beyond our current vaccine. Diphtheria, a highly contagious and life-threatening infection, affects the nose, throat, and sometimes skin, and is spread by coughing, sneezing, and direct contact. It is usually caused by the toxin produced by the bacterium C. diphtheriae, although systemic infections with non-toxic C. diphtheria can occur. Although babies in the UK and other high-income countries are often vaccinated against the disease, sporadic outbreaks still occur in other parts of the world. And the number of reported cases is increasing, from an annual average of 8,105 cases between 1996 and 2017 to 16,651 in 2019, the onset of the COVID-19 crisis, meanwhile, has delayed childhood immunization schedules against diphtheria around the world, compounding the problem, according to the team. In their study, the researchers sequenced the genomes of 61 bacteria isolated from patients and combined them with publicly available data on 411 other C. diphtheriae variants to map the relationship and spread of the different outbreaks. The team's analysis revealed the existence of genetically similar groups of C. diphtheriae on several continents, especially in Asia and Europe, indicating that the bacterium has established itself in the human population and has migrated with it for at least a century. Genomic data also revealed the presence of genes that confer antimicrobial resistance and toxin variation. Diphtheria toxin is the main disease-causing component of the bacterium, and is encoded by the so-called tox gene, of which the team found 18 different variants, several of which had the potential to alter the structure of the toxin. The diphtheria vaccine is designed to neutralize the toxin, so any genetic variant that changes the structure of the toxin could have an impact on the efficacy of the vaccine, said article author Gordon Dougan of the University of Cambridge. Our data do not suggest that the current vaccine is ineffective. However, he added, the fact that we are seeing an increasing diversity of toxin variants suggests that the vaccine, and toxin-targeted treatments, should be evaluated on a regular basis. In terms of antimicrobial resistance, the team found that the number of resistance genes per genome has increased, and that bacteria from the last decade have four times as many as those from the 1990s. The C. diphtheriae genome is complex and incredibly diverse. It is gaining resistance to antibiotics that are not even used clinically in the treatment of diphtheria, explained the article's author, Robert Will of Cambridge University. There must be other factors at play, such as asymptomatic infection and exposure to a plethora of antibiotics intended to treat other diseases, he added. It is more important than ever to understand how diphtheria evolves and spreads, added article author and infectious disease researcher Ankur Mutraja. Genome sequencing provides us with a powerful tool to observe this in real time, allowing public health agencies to take action before it is too late, said the Cambridge expert. We must not lose sight of diphtheria. Otherwise, we risk it becoming a major global threat again, potentially in a modified and better adapted form. Our data do not suggest that the current vaccine is ineffective. However, he added, The fact that we are seeing an increasing diversity of toxin variants suggests that the vaccine and toxin-targeted treatments should be evaluated on a regular basis. In terms of antimicrobial resistance, the team found that the number of resistance genes per genome has increased, with bacteria from the last decade being four times as large as those from the 1990s. The C. diphtheriae genome is complex and incredibly diverse. It is gaining resistance to antibiotics that are not even used clinically in the treatment of diphtheria, explained the article's author, Robert Will of Cambridge University. There must be other factors at play, such as asymptomatic infection and exposure to a plethora of antibiotics intended to treat other diseases, he added. It is more important than ever to understand how diphtheria evolves and spreads, added article author and infectious disease researcher Ankur Mutraja. Genome sequencing provides us with a powerful tool to observe this in real time, allowing public health agencies to take action before it is too late, said the Cambridge expert. We must not lose sight of diphtheria, otherwise we risk it becoming a major global threat again, potentially in a modified and better adapted form. What is diphtheria? Carine bacterium diphtheriae is the pathogenic bacterium that causes diphtheria. It is also known as the Klebsiella bacillus, because it was discovered in 1884 by German bacteriologists Edwin Klebs and Friedrich Loeffler. Scientific name, Carine bacterium diphtheriae. Higher classification, Carine bacterium order, Actinomycetes phylum, Actinobacteria rank, species.